a simple question, because I don't know really how to lead into it, because it deals with salary cap and math, and I'm not good with that stuff at all. I go on Cap Friendly like all the time, and I still don't understand how some of this stuff works. Do you think Mark Bergevin has completely mismanaged his salary cap situation, or do you think he's a victim of circumstances? Obviously, with all the injuries that have come and all the injury recalls and whatnot he's had to make over the last few weeks, do you think he's more of a victim of that, or do you think he's just really messed up his salary cap situation?
Yes. Yes, I'll need to add.
Yeah, that's fine.
I worry he messed it up, I think, is with the Cole Caulfield situation. It's not like they didn't know Cole Caulfield was going to be leaving University of Wisconsin after this season. He wasn't going back for a third year. Cole Caulfield wanted to go to the NHL the day he was drafted.
Yes. You know,
they knew he was coming. They knew this is a team that can't score goals. They should have been prepared for when Caulfield came out to get him in the lineup. The fact they didn't makes me wonder if maybe they weren't planning to put him in the lineup this season, which brings up a whole other question. But, you know, getting Gustafsson and Merrill at the trade deadline made it more difficult. I understand Bergevin wanted depth on defense, but to have a team struggling to score goals and having a natural goal scorer sitting there waiting to come in and then not being able to get him in the lineup, That doesn't look good on the GM or the people handling the salary cap and the recall situation and everything else. You know, not just the salary cap, but they screwed up the recall situation too, right at the trade deadline. So, you know, to not be able to have Cole Caulfield sitting there, and even if they didn't want to get him in or weren't thinking about him getting him, but not even having the option to get him in if they wanted him in, that's a screw up in my mind.
And I think Dominique Ducharme was probably getting kind of annoyed when they would ask, you know, is Caulfield going to play? Well, it's almost like math class. Bring out the chalkboard for him to, in order to play. This has to happen. This has to happen. But yeah, you know, this didn't just happen accidentally and say, oh no, how did we run into this situation? You know, you're an NHL team. You have people on the salary to make sure that you don't get into a situation like this, to tell you how to avoid it. And they're down this road where it's very difficult for them right now. And it's not the point of the season where you want to be limited on what you can do. And especially when you're having trouble scoring goals and not being able to bring a player that could potentially be a spark plug, or having to send a Romanov to the taxi squad. This is not the ideal situation. And yes, this is Mark Bergevin's fault, because he is the general manager of this team and should have consulted with the group around him to find out, how do I avoid going down this path and being limited in the choices for who I can put in the lineup?
And maybe he didn't want Caulfield to come to the main team. You know, it makes you wonder that, you know, if that was the case, okay, that's the way it played out. Or, you know, could he have done something to, you know, try and work it so that he could have an opportunity to be part of the lineup earlier? I mean, it's a tough situation. You know, as I said, the numbers have to line up, the rules have to line up. There's a lot of things that come into play. There's a lot of guys that maybe are on the priority that some think should be priority and they're not. So it's what it is. You know, moving forward, the scenario is what we see is the guys that are going to carry this group right through now to the end, and it's up to them now to make it happen, because there's nothing more that Bergevin can do or should have, could have, is now passé, and now it's time to deal with what the current group is and find ways to get their act together.
Yeah, you might have hit the nail on the head there, Rick. Maybe Bergevin didn't want or wasn't planning to have Caulfield on the team this year. Maybe that's what went into the thinking. You know, they had meetings with John Sedgwick, the guy who handles the cap, and Bergevin and everybody else. But, you know, as they say, you hope for the best and prepare for the worst in any kind of management position. And you would hope that at one point they said, okay, if we want to get Cole Caulfield in the lineup, tell me what I can and what I can't do. And maybe they did have that meeting, and he said, you can't do this, you won't be able to get him in. And Bergevin said, okay, I'll live with that. We never know what goes on in those meetings. But as I said, to have Cole Caulfield sitting there and not even having the option to bring him up if he wanted to, I think was a mistake.
Yeah, and, you know, Caulfield height maybe didn't come from the general manager's office. I mean, I don't know, but you would think that there would have been some ways to get around that. But like Julian said, math was not one of my And, you know, it's what it is. So now let's deal with what they got and make things happen.
Yeah, maybe Bergevin's plan with Caulfield was similar to what they did with Romanov last year, where they would have let him finish the season with the Rocket, bring him up to have sort of playoffs and just sort of give him the experience about being around the team and then come to training camp next year and try and earn a spot. So maybe that was his thinking. We'll never know.
I guess not. I'm not sure if we'll ever know. Oh, maybe he might say something, I guess. Visit hockeyinsideout.com to check out our full episode and let us know what you think of how Marc Bergevin has handled his salary cap issues in the comment section below.